Okay, so in last century in Portugal, forests have increased a lot. And why is that? There were a lot of shrublands and grasslands. Anyway, the mainly works with the maritime pine and also eucalyptus. And but it's we have a large area, as you know, of Mediterranean oaks, cork oak and evergreen oak. So we can say that we have some kind of good balance. That's my opinion. In the most used species, the forest species. Okay, now that's the picture you know very well. And the right side we have the species, forest species distribution. Okay, so briefly, this is what we foresters call the Atlantic Arc. That's the Atlantic climate influence. And we have here, that's the good side from maritime pine and eucalyptus. And here in the south, the cork oak, the cork oak most in the Atlantic, also in the still Atlantic influence, and the evergreen oak in the more arid influence. Anyway, for the eucalyptus business, we must say that eucalyptus is okay everywhere the maritime pine will be, but till the 450 meters high. Anyway, in the last years, people of the pulp and paper companies begin to use eucalyptus nitens. That's an altitude eucalyptus. That's a mountain species. And presently, we can have eucalyptus stands till 800 meters, even. Well, just for the main species that we have about presently we have about 800,000 hectares of eucalyptus. And about 700,000 hectares of maritime pine stands, and in the south the cork oak pine, about 600,000 hectares. That's the third species. And with all that, we can see that in Portugal, in terms of forest area, we are very close to the average of the European countries area. So European 37% and Portugal 38%. We can also say that according with present land use, forests still have a lot of possibilities to develop, because we have 32% of shrublands and grasslands, and 2% of unproductive. So it's still a good news to forest industry. Okay, now this showed the evolution of the forested areas since the 60s. Till here, this work His works were made only with owner's financial or state financial. And after that, they came to be made with European financial. Well, this talk, I believe that will be a top forum for next year still. It shows that that forest owners remain with more doubts about the forest investment, mostly in the maritime pine stands. Well, I think I'm gonna test this. Just to say, okay, that we have 3.3 million hectares, and more or less half and half wood stands and broadleaves areas. Okay, this picture is interesting, in my opinion. It's a study that was made by that gentleman, and shows an approach of the value of the forest value, but not only in the direct use values like wood production or cork production, but also with indirect use values like as protection, carbon sequestration, and landscape and biodiversity protection. So it shows that we have in Portugal a good component of direct use values, wood products, and another direct use values, mostly pasture. And some hunting and some game and some recreation. In terms of the Mediterranean area, we have a new position in this approach. Okay, so we can say that Portuguese forest has capabilities that allow its development towards sustainability. Why? Because we presently, there is a high and sustained growth worldwide demand for forest products. The forests and forest products are usually considered environmentally friendly. And we have good soil and climate conditions, and we have land availability for expansion. Okay, now going through the 60s, the early 60s, the technical approach, the forest services have developed these techniques and good practices, and the most was the concept of minimum tillage. The installation in conformity with contour of the land, trench and bound techniques, net grasslands used with forest systems, torrent control, and use of natural regeneration. That's an example of forest equipment that was used those days. Okay, we can say that it begins with animal work and very low productivities, but also very low impact in water, soil, and biodiversity. Presently, we have these little monsters with full of horsepowers, but with also the problems of soil impact,
sound impacts,
and sometimes also in water and biodiversity. Okay, why does forest defended that these techniques were the most interesting in protection and soil conservation? Basically, as you can see, and maybe a lot of you already see this kind of words, it's very important to let some shrub and grass between the plantation lines, and it's better like this. Okay, here's an example of a plantation. It's a cork oak plantation in the south, and the technique here was trench and bound, and with this. This is of land with natural vegetation. Our good practice also includes some works of in areas of concentration and rainwater, and some works for conservative and restore the water lines. Okay, now that's an example of plantation of Porto. We have here the natural vegetation that remains in the site, and we use presently these protective cylinders. I don't know if you are if you know already the use of these cylinders, but it's mostly to improve the growing height of the plant, and also to protect from some kind of some animals that could damage them. Okay, we have talked about the area of the. This picture is from Sinch, and there's a maritime pine natural regeneration use. It's the aim is to, in 5 or 10 years, to go there and to make lines of young plants with a minimum mechanization. So let's show you this. Now that's an example in the north. The north is the mountain conditions are a little more difficult. Anyway, there's an evolution of this site plantation of maritime pine 25 years later. Okay, so this picture showed us the evolution of areas forested between the in the first 30 years of this period. Okay, in the presently we have this distribution in terms of plantation areas in the last 50 years. In the last years we must accept the more interesting for the eucalyptus investment and to understand. Anyway, I think that still we have some kind of good balance with more or less eucalyptus and other branch leaves. And eucalyptus and other branch leaves, which means deciduous branch leaves, which means oaks. It's more or less balanced. Okay. Now this is the results of the National Forest Inventory. It's a work that is made every 10 years and show the big picture as the forest is in terms of the species and the areas. And as we can see here, the forest area still increase, not a lot, because the problem of forest fires that every year happens in our forest. Okay, that's the present situation. Present situation of the forest is eucalyptus with, in first place, eucalyptus stands, eucalyptus areas. Secondly, the cork oak and the maritime pine. They are more or less equal in terms of areas, but the tendency is that the maritime pine will decrease because of the sanitary problems. Now this picture shows how the three main species have evolved on this 50 years, and it's very very clear that the maritime pine stands and areas have decreased, and the eucalyptus walls became the first species on our forest. What happened these last 2 years? These are the areas of the projects approved in our service in the last 2 years. And here the picture is a little different. Eucalyptus 44%. We are talking about new projects. Last 2 years, this is cork oak, and a new species with interest in present days at the umbrella pine, mostly because of the fruit production. Anyway. I must say this 44% percent of forestation with eucalyptus means that 80% of that area is reforestation, actually. It means that I have all of this area, the increase of the eucalyptus area in the country was corresponding with it's about more or less about 2,000 hectares. The question is that, and this is a question that we foresters discuss a lot, which is why to improve new areas with eucalyptus stands when we have about, let us say, 150,000 hectares of eucalyptus stands in the end of the cycle, in the production cycle. And more that areas were the first areas that pulp and paper companies installed in the early 60s. So, these areas are in the most productive regions for the eucalyptus. So it seems a little bit stupid, to increase area, new areas for the eucalyptus, and trying to put mountain eucalyptus of mountain species to catch areas above the eucalyptus global's limit. When I have here all this region are plain of eucalyptus, old eucalyptus stands that are just waiting to be reforested and to answer the needs of our industry. Just to say that all the years, each year, pulp and paper companies, Portuguese pulp and paper companies, import a lot of eucalyptus sheepwood from, well, mostly from the South America, presently Argentina, Brazil, and Chile, but also, and that's interesting, from the north of Spain, Galicia. The Galicia owners in the last 20 years forest more than 500 hectares with eucalyptus bulbs. Now, that eucalyptus bulbs are coming down by trucks, which is very expensive, but and we have here those areas that we could also start production again. But anyway, now I would like to talk about a project we have in our organization wants to, as the objective, to assess impacts of afforestation in soil biodiversity conservation in the semi-arid region, which means that we are talking about all these areas, and just for understand that a species, a forest species, that is more well, that goes well in this area, better, is the evergreen oak. But in the last 40 years or 50 years, forest owners of this semi-arid region want to try cork oak instead of evergreen oak. And I think that we understand why. The cork oak, the expectation of cork oak production was very interesting in terms of incoming, economic incoming. But we foresters trying to tell these people that it was not a wise decision, because in long term the cork production, it was very dumped in those areas, and what we can see today is that those plantations, they were mixed with a conifer, mostly the umbrella pine, sometimes written pine, but mostly umbrella pine and cork oak. And what happens 50 years then, on most plantations, the cork oak didn't grow, and we have stands of maritim, of umbrella pine, pure stand of umbrella pine. Anyway, what we want to do is to study parcels on these areas and try to understand what are the better situation in terms of soils and water and biodiversity and carbon sequestration. Now this is an example that that we can use the snapshots of the of our forest inventory, national forest inventory. For instance, this here we compare what was evergreen and cork oak, evergreen oak and cork oak in 1905. There are the rows, the pink points, to what were 50 years later, grassland or brush. So everything that you can see, these are three municipalities of those Miari region. All you can see in blue, there were areas less than 50 years were degraded from evergreen or cork oak stand to brush. That's an example of what we can do with this this national fund inventory snapshots. That's an example of what we can go further in deep and trying to understand what happened in those areas. Okay, so we want to select in this semi-arid zone a lot of stands. Our objective is to find this kind of old plantations of mix with cork oak and conifers. This is a left pine lupensis, Pinus lupensis, and this one is one of them. What then that 50 years after still have the oak, but here the owner also didn't do the right thing in our opinion, which means that he didn't cut the conifer in the first 20 years of life of the plantation. That's why the cork oak stays too little for the age. And okay, well, the conifer it's very well. Thank you. This also the type of areas we want to study in these areas. This is a plantation of maritime of the umbrella pine with cork oaks and this is Ferruzzonedus. I don't know how the English words. Okay. That's this plantation. That's a very young one. It has 8-10 years. That's anyway. These kind of areas are what we are looking for. To develop our studies. So we will characterize the project from the perspective of various soil climate descriptors, which are, and we collect all these data in the site, and on that one, that's the usually data we collect in forests work. This is a project for 5 years, we hope. And we also made demonstration of dissemination activities. And we will also hope to extend this approach to study of forest areas where we perform professional works. Thank you, and please forgive my poor English. I still don't know why I understand so good spoken English, and I speak so badly in the same language. Thank you.